Hi friends, welcome to the video on supply chain management interview questions and answers from CareerLite. Maintaining a supply chain is essential not only for the success of a business, but also the convenience of the customers so that they have access to the required goods when needed. And the effort that goes behind making these goods available at the right place at the right time is the job of supply chain management. So all of you who are interested to be in this profession or are already a part of it, must see this video completely as we discuss some important questions that may be asked at your interview too. Let's begin and stay connected till the end. Okay, so before I begin, if you are someone new to our channel or if you have not subscribed to it yet, I highly recommend doing it now because we are committed to get you videos that will help you prosper in your career. Also, press the bell icon next to the subscribe button. It will ensure that you are notified every time we release a new career video and you don't miss out on anything important. Fantastic. Let's see question number one. And the first question that we have got here is, what is supply chain management? What are its advantages? Well, to answer this question, you can say, supply chain is a connected network of all the individuals, companies, resources, activities, and technologies that are needed for the manufacturing and sale of a product or service. And managing the chain of supplies is supply chain management. Now, talking about the advantages of having a supply chain management. Having an effective supply chain management allows you to have a better relationship with the suppliers, which ultimately leads to better productivity and reduced costs. Accurate sales and demand forecast also improve your inventory management, which protects you from both over and under production. And this helps you in using your resources optimally. And hence, improved cash flow and better profits are what you see. Having supply chain management in place also allows you to create and seize new opportunities in the market. Quick decision making with updated information at your disposal also allows you to mitigate many risks, which may otherwise impact your business negatively. So these are the major advantages of supply chain management that you can talk about to answer this question. Well, that was quite a simple question to begin the interview with. But this is how most of the interviews start, with something basic and simple. And once the tone of the interview is set, the questions start getting deeper. Let's see question number two now. What are the building blocks of SCM? To answer this question, you can say, there are basically 8 building blocks of SCM. They are strategic planning, demand planning, supply planning, procurement, manufacturing, warehousing, order fulfillment, and transportation. If you want, you can also talk about the elements that constitute these building blocks. I've mentioned them here for you. Then, digitization has become an important part of every aspect of business, and even SCM is not untouched with it. So the next question that may be asked to you could be, what do you know about digital SCM? To answer this question, you can say, you can understand digital SCM as a supply chain that makes use of digital technologies like Internet of Things, robotic process automation, artificial intelligence, blockchain, cloud computing, etc. A lot of companies are moving into this space for the various advantages it brings to the business. Some of the basic advantages of digital SCM are, number one, ease of integrating and sharing the information in real time. Then it gives you visibility into the operations of SCM. Accuracy in supply and demand planning, even in case of shortage of material or orders that come in late into the process, is another advantage that it offers you. At number four is lesser risk in the whole process into the planning that is based on information. And then better optimized and integrated manufacturing process on account of updated data that you have. It also provides for efficient transportation and global trade management that offer better compliance and reduced cost. Another advantage that it offers is improved customer engagement and customer satisfaction that is derived on account of better decision making. And if you put all of this together, it boils down to increased revenue and earnings. Now, as we just discussed, a lot of companies are moving into the digital SEM space. And if you're applying for a little senior role, there is a high possibility that one of your responsibilities would be to get their SEM digitized. Any company would hire you when they're sure that you'll be able to handle the process. And one of the questions that they may ask you to check your suitability could be, what are the main challenges that you expect to face on your road to digital SEM? To answer this question, you can say, the challenges that we may face while moving towards digital SEM can be divided into two basic types. The first one is technological, and the second type is management based. The challenges at technological front can include but not limited to things like choosing the right mix of technology for our kind of business, integrating numerous disparate systems, and adding newer things and processes to the system. Now, talking about the challenges on the management side, this would majorly include things like letting go of some old processes and incorporating some newer ones to ensure that the implementation of new technologies gives you desired results. If you are not willing to change your operational ways, implementation of newer technology may prove to be more harmful than being profitable actually. The next question that we have got here is again a very important one. Please pay attention. What is supply chain integration? What do you think is its purpose? To answer this question, you can say, supply chain integration is a business strategy that tries to bring as many links as possible in the supply chain closer to each other in a working relationship. The purpose of supply chain integration is to get more cost-effective products to the market with a better understanding about your customers and avoiding any kind of wastage of raw material or time. Secondly, it tries to reduce the time it takes to get a final product to the market. And then it allows you to adapt better to the changes and expectations in the marketplace and also catch any warning signs early in the life cycle with the help of better information that is available at your disposal. The integrations are majorly of two types. The first one is horizontal integration and the second one is vertical integration. Now, the reason companies try to look out for solutions like SCM integration or digital SCM or anything else is to deal with the challenges faced by the supply chain. In one of the previous questions, we talked about the challenges that you may face while implementing digital SCM. But the next question could be a little more general, and it could be something like, what are some of the biggest challenges faced in the supply chain? Your answer to this kind of a question demonstrates your awareness about the work. To answer this question, you may say something like, some of the major challenges that we face every day in the supply chain are certain very general things. And these include things like unavailability of workers, changes in the order and last minute cancellations, unexpected failures in the manufacturing facility or software, hampered supply of raw materials, conflict in the commitment of suppliers to us and other customers, and limited opportunities to communicate in the chain. If we can solve some of these general problems, the supply chain of most of the companies can improve drastically. Question number 7. What are some of the trends that have started to set in lately in the field of supply chain management? Now see, every field always sees the coming in of newer trends. And so is SCM witnessing them. The trends that I'm going to discuss here have already begun to show up, and they'll continue for many years to come. The trend that we have got at number 1 is supply chains getting greener, with many companies accepting their used products for a recycle. This is mostly happening with the electronic gadgets and mobile phones at the moment. A lot of supply chains are even getting paperless with the use of software throughout the process, which is also an initiative towards a green supply chain. Trend number 2 that is getting very popular is the businesses using AI and machine learning to connect better with their customers and suppliers. Also, automation has begun to rule the supply chain, with ERPs and warehouse management systems getting installed in many companies, streamlining the work better. In fact, early demand planning is also setting in with the help of effective data-based forecast. Another trend that is gaining a lot of momentum in the industry is the use of cloud-based technologies. These technologies are being increasingly used both by large and small business houses. They provide them with the benefit of using advanced technology without investing heavily in technical infrastructure. And with all this, definitely arise the security issues. So there's a lot of emphasis on digital security to keep your supply chain safe from any cyber attacks. So these are the major trends that you can talk about to answer this question. Moving on to question number 8. What is supply chain risk management? What strategies would you advise to mitigate the risks in SCM? To answer this question, you can say SCRM or supply chain risk management. It's a set of synchronized efforts and activities that help you identify, monitor, and eliminate the factors which may harm your supply chain. These factors may be external or internal. Now, to mitigate these risks, some of the strategies that you can use are, number one, have a risk management model in place. This model should have a plan to prevent the risks in the first place. And if they somehow occur, you should be prepared to respond to them with a contingency plan and stand back on your feet with a recovery plan. Then always evaluate your suppliers for their commitment to deliver the agreed material and their financial stability. Many credit rating agencies provide ratings to the suppliers all over that can help you in deciding on the right supplier for yourself. Have a backup to manage the environmental risk or face any natural disasters. Also, have a cybersecurity plan and process in place. Then, sensitize your staff and team towards the potential risks and train them to deal with these risks. Also, train them to identify and report any early signs of the risk. The risks identified early in the process give you the time to work out your plan of action. And lastly, have a monitoring plan in place. Just having a risk mitigation plan in place is not going to help you avoid them. You'll need to consistently monitor them and make the required changes to your strategy if required. Now that we are done with these questions, I would advise you to be prepared to answer some more traditional questions also, like various terms used in SCM, their practical applications, etc. That will be quite useful to you in dealing with the interview. So guys, this is all from my side in this video. I'll keep coming back to you with more such topics, but if there's anything specific that you want me to cover, do let me know by commenting in the box below. I promise to read all your comments. If you have found this video useful, do give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. To stay updated, subscribe to the channel. I'll see you very soon with a new video. Thank you and bye-bye till then.